to first, but Delly Fox loses his footing. Lee Foyer is home safe with a third Yankee tally to tie it up. The New Yorkers fail to score again, and the game goes into extra innings. Yankee southpaw Fred Kipp, the fourth New York hurler so far, is greeted in the 10th with a single off the bat of Minnie Minoso. Ted Kozinski follows with a slashing one-bagger to right, and Minoso comes flying in the third.
Right now I am joined by former Dodger pitcher Fred Kipp. Thank you so much for taking a few moments to chat with us. Very thrilled to have you out here today, throwing out the first pitch here. Let's hear it for former Dodger Fred Kipp. Anybody? Yes. All right, so 1953, I'm going to take you back. Let's hear story time here, okay? So you were signed as an amateur free agent. Tell us a little bit about how you became a Dodger.
Well, like I said, I pitched in college. It was a different back then. I played in small towns in South Dakota, Nebraska, Kansas, and I played in college. I played basketball and baseball in college, Emporia State University. Got to get that plug in.
Of course. Now, you were a part of the Brooklyn Dodgers when they played at Ebbets Field. Tell us a little bit about what it was like playing at Ebbets Field.
Ebbets Field. I was there at the end of 56, and I'd won 20 games in Montreal, and I came up at the end of the year. And they won the pennant that year. I didn't have much to do with it, but I was there.
After that, the Dodgers moved all the way across the country from Brooklyn here to Los Angeles. They started playing in LA at the Coliseum. What was it like playing at the Coliseum, a place not necessarily meant for baseball?
Well, 210 feet to left field. That's pretty short for a left-handed pitcher facing right-handed hitters. But I got to stay all year.
Which is a plus.
I ended up 6-6. Uh-huh. 3 in relief, 3 in starting.
Any memorable moments from those starts at the Coliseum?
Well, I won my first one against the Cardinals. Stan Musial went 4-for-4, but I won the game.
Which is all that matters at the end of the day. He won his first start at the Coliseum.
I'd take that every day of the week and twice on Sunday.
Absolutely. Well, Fred, thank you so much for spending a few moments with us today. We want to wish you luck throwing out the ceremonial first pitch, so thank you so much. Fred Kipp, everybody.
Thank you.
And for their first two seasons in Los Angeles, including 1959, the year the team won their second World Series. Please welcome back former Dodger pitcher Fred Kipp. Nice pitch, Mr. Kipp.
Hi, everybody, and a very pleasant Sunday to you. Welcome to Dodger Stadium, final game of the series with Arizona, and the final game of a pretty successful homestand. The Dodgers, by taking two from Arizona, now have the edge 3-2. Arizona trails by 5. The Dodgers lead San Diego by 3. The Arizona Diamondbacks are struggling, and they're unlucky losing a game when the runner is hit by a batted ball last night. But they've also lost 6 of the last 8, and no doubt are very unhappy about playing here at Dodger Stadium. So those are some numbers, maybe something to think about as you sit back and enjoy the beautiful weather. But above all, what we want for you, we hope you have a wonderful day at the ballpark.
Fans, it's now time for the words that are recited before each and every game here at Dodger Stadium. Take it away, Mr. Kipp.
It's time for Dodger baseball.